Blackstone Audio presents Unraveled, a Red River Mystery by Reavis Z. Wortham. This book is read by Traber Burns. This book is dedicated to the Hunting Club, a loose, unofficial group of outdoorsmen I've camped, fished, and hunted with for the last 30 years. Thanks to the original core group, Larry Williams, Jerry Halpin, Dr. Gary Reeves, and Pat Chumley, for providing the fun, laughs, and inspiration that created the syndicated newspaper column, which morphed into the gang from Doreen's 24-hour Eat Gas Now Cafe, and eventually provided the author's voice that led to the Red River series. Chapter 1. Grandpa Ned always said our quiet little country community in northeast Texas was like a stock pond, calm and smooth on the surface, so there's not much to look at, but full of life and death down below. Center Springs wasn't much to see back in 1968. I guess what you'd call the hub of our community was an unpainted domino hall squatting between two clapboard country stores at the intersection of Farm to Market Road 197 that ran east and west, and FM 906 that started there and crossed the Lamar County Dam. A skinny county oil road angled to the northwest behind the Domino Hall and past the Ordway Place, a fine two-story house full of ghosts and bad memories. Mostly all you ever saw up at the stores were a few farmers loafing either on Uncle Neil's porch, where we did most of our trading, or under the overhang at Oak Peterson's competing store that carried the same staples, plus gas. Houses were scattered beside pastures full of fat cattle everywhere along Sanders Creek and the Red River bottoms. Those small scratch farms that survived the Great Depression and hung on tight to the land had been in the same families for generations. A lot of folks lived way back in the woods off dirt and gravel roads. Most waved when they saw you, except for a few old soreheads who turned away so they wouldn't have to wave back. Since he was constable of Precinct 3, Grandpa got called out both night and day for more than you'd expect for such a small place. There were family fights, reports of whiskey stills, misunderstandings, cattle on the roads, fist fights, farm accidents, or car wrecks. Because of a cluster of cinderblock beer joints called Juarez across the river in Oklahoma, not 5 miles away, drunks came weaving through our little community most every week. Most of the time, Grandpa pulled them over and hauled them to jail in nearby Chisum, the county seat, but sometimes he came along to find cars all torn to pieces and bodies on the road or in a ditch or slammed into trees. The ones that made Grandpa the maddest was them that took other good folks with him. It was a car wreck only a few weeks after Reverend King had been laid to rest that tangled Grandpa Ned up in what folks started calling the Lamar County accident. Oh, and I'm Top Parker, and this is how we wound up in the middle of all that trouble. Chapter 2. The scruffy man slipped out of the house in his stocking feet. The eastern sky would soon brighten, but he'd be long gone by then. He'd stood in the shadows for a long time, watching the sleeping couple tangled in the damp sheets and listening to their soft breathing. He sat on the edge of the porch, as if he owned the place, pulled on his shoes, and walked in the open until he reached the woods, not caring that he left a trail in the wet grass. It might make it more fun if they noticed. The Motorola mounted under the Plymouth's dash squawked. Deputy Anna Sloan's soft voice cut through the static. "Ned, you there?" The slender deputy was on desk duty, working dispatch after nearly dying from a gunshot wound early in the fall. It always startled Ned to hear Deputy Sloan on the radio instead of Martha Wells. Martha had worked the day shift on dispatch for 30 years. Without taking his eyes off the road, Constable Ned Parker leaned over and turned the volume up to drown out the stock report coming through the dash radio. His grandkids in the back seat sat forward to hear. 15-year-old cousins Top and Pepper were so similar in appearance that strangers thought they were twins, though Top was unusually short for his age. Ned plucked the microphone off the bracket.
Right here.
There's been a bad wreck on the Lake Lamar Dam. Somebody missed the curve and went off the backside.
Oh, my God.
In the passenger seat, Ned's Choctaw wife, Miss Becky, covered her mouth and closed her eyes, saying a quick prayer for those in the car. Ned stomped the foot feed, and the Plymouth Fury's big engine roared. They were on Highway 271, and at the loop.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.